Good afternoon, Sabbath night students. Today I shall be teaching you Act 2, Scene 3. In this particular scene, we shall be introduced to Jessica. She is the daughter of Shylock. Jessica is in love with a Christian by the name of Lorenzo. Lorenzo, we had come to know in Act 1, Scene 1, when he accompanies Graciano and Bassanio to meet Antonio. Okay. So, now Lorenzo is a Christian, and this love affair will not be successful. Then again, we go back to the previous scene where Bassanio instructs Gobbo and Lancelot to go to your old master Jew's house and take leave. Okay. Tell him that you are leaving his services. So, Lancelot has come to inform Shylock that he is leaving his services. So before he could meet Shylock, he has met Jessica. Okay. Now this scene takes place in Venice, a room in Shylock's house. Now enter Jessica and Lancelot. Jessica, I am sorry thou will leave my father's soul. He says, I am feeling so sad that you are going to leave my father's services. Our house is hell. Now here we come to know that Jessica is not happy living in her father's house. So she considers that house a hell and thou a merry devil. Now usually devils live in hell, okay, but here she is referring to Lancelot that you are a merry devil, means you are a happy-go-lucky fellow. This robbed of some taste of tediousness. Okay, now you were a merry devil means you were a very fun-loving person. You would make me laugh. You would say funny things. You would even remove my boredom. I will be missing it. Once you leave, then there is nobody to entertain me. There is nobody to keep me company. There is nobody will be there to make me laugh when I am in an off mood, like how we used to do. So she feels that once Lancelot leaves the job, this part of her life now is going to be worse. At least Lancelot was there to keep her company and to make her laugh whenever she would be lonely or sad. Okay. Fare thee well. There is a ducat for thee. And Lancelot, soon at supper shall thou see Lorenzo, who is thy new master's guest. Give him this letter, do it secretly, and so farewell. I would not have my father see me talk with thee. Okay. Now she is feeling very sad that Lancelot will be leaving her father's services. There will not be anybody there to keep her company or to make her laugh. All that. Then she gives Lancelot a ducat. And she says, here is a letter. Now, when you join your new master's house, he will be having a feast. He will be having a party. And in that party, there will be a person by the one of the guests. His name will be Lorenzo. So take this letter and give it to him secretly. Now this ducat which Jessica is giving Launcelot, it is not a farewell gift. Okay, remember she is a Jew, she is a miser. She will only spend money where she finds her own benefit. So she is bribing Launcelot and telling him that now take this ducat and in your new master's party there will be a guest by the name of Lorenzo. Give him this letter and do it secretly. And bye bye, fare you well. Because now I don't want my father should see me talking to you. Because obviously her father will be annoyed because Launcelot is going to leave the job. Okay. Now, Launcelot, adieu. Adieu means bye bye, goodbye. Tears exhibit my tongue. Actually, it is inhibit. Now the tears are preventing him from speaking. He is unable to express himself through words. Most beautiful pagan, most sweet Jew, if a Christian do not play the name and get thee, I am much deceived. But adieu, these foolish drops do somewhat drown my manly spirit. Adieu. Okay, so goodbye, he says. The tears are preventing me from speaking. And then he plays a fool again. He says, if that Christian, that if Lorenzo does not treat you well, or if he cheats on you, then I think I should get a chance. Then I will not be deceived. Means he is anticipating when Lorenzo will break up with Jessica. And then he will fall in love with Jessica. Now whether he is serious about it or he is just kidding, we don't know. But he is definitely conveying the message that he hopes that Lorenzo shouldn't cheat him. Because one is a Christian and one is a Jew. Okay. Then again, now Jessica says, farewell, good Launcelot. Now, Launcelot leaves. Here, Jessica is found expressing her feelings. Okay? Now she is speaking to herself. When an actor speaks to himself or herself on the stage, this dialogue is called a soliloquy. Okay? So if they say, who is the speaker speaking to? Then you have to answer that she is speaking to nobody. This speech of hers is a soliloquy. Now, she is saying that I am feeling ashamed that I am Shylock's daughter. She is feeling ashamed of herself that she is the daughter of a man called Shylock. But I cannot help it. I am his flesh and blood. I have a blood relationship with my father. Okay. But I have not inculcated the Jewish manner in me. All the characteristics, negative characteristics of the Jew, I have not inculcated. I may be his daughter, but I have not inculcated any of his bad habits. Okay. So, then she tells, like she is speaking to herself. She says, if Lorenzo, if you keep your promise that you will stand by me, then I shall end this strife. Means I shall end this problem. Now from the earlier scene we come to know that the Jews and the Christians don't get it on. They don't get along well. So on no account, no way Shylock is going to accept Lorenzo as a son-in-law, he being a Christian, above all. So she says, if you stand by me, I shall end this trial. Means she will run away with him. She will convert herself into a Christian and be his loving wife. So here we come to know the difference between the way Portia is dealing with her marriage life. She, though she didn't like what her father has devised for her, but she is an obedient girl. She is loyal to her father. Here we see Jessica is betraying her father. Not only betraying her father, she's also betraying the Jewish tribe. Okay, or the Jews. So I shall end it till here. And I have sent some soft copies, question answers. Read the lesson, write and learn the given question and answers. Thank you.